Welcome to the PSID web tutorial on the Family Identification Mapping System, or FIMS. FIMS is a special online tool that allows the user to create pairs of related family members in the PSID. If you're new to the PSID, please see the web tutorial titled An Introduction to the Panel Study of Income Dynamics. FIMS creates a customized map file that contains the identification variables of the relatives you choose to examine. For example, you may be interested in biological grandparents as the relative of interest. FIMS would then generate a file that contained the IDs of all individuals with that relationship who have a 1968 ID and person number. The shapes available are wide, which in this example is defined as one observation per grandchild, and long, which would be defined as one observation per grandchild-grandparent pair. You would then create an individual-level data file and merge it with the FIMS file to match them to children and their corresponding grandparents. FIMS offers three distinct types of maps. The first is an intragenerational sibling map, which allows the identification of various types of siblings, both full siblings and half siblings. The intergenerational GID map matches PSID individuals to their predecessors, going back up to three generations, from children to parents, grandparents, and great-grandparents. This intergenerational map is retrospective in nature. That is, it starts with an individual and goes back along his or her family lineage. Please note that as of the 2015 data release, additional individuals from various family roster modules were added to the retrospective GID map. If these individuals were never present in a PSID family unit, they will have a person number of 800 and above. If you're not interested in these additional relationships, you can drop the individuals with person numbers in that range. Finally, in 2014, a prospective intergenerational map, GID Pro, was added to FIMS. Here, the starting generation, G1, is the original sample from 1968. Descendants of original PSID households form subsequent generations. Again, up to three generations down, where G2 is the child, G3 is the grandchild, and G4 is the great-grandchild. The prospective generation map format is long, meaning that each row is a distinct set of individuals observed in the PSID. The map also provides biological relation, father or mother, between individuals and generation position of all individuals listed on each row. Please note that due to the prospective nature of the GID Pro, only individuals ever observed in a PSID family unit are included as the first generation. We'll now take you through an example of how to use FIMS. In this exercise, we'll demonstrate how FIMS can be used to link PSID grandchildren with their grandparents using the intergenerational GID map. One of the key features of the PSID is its ability to link multiple generations together. Before we continue with the web tutorial, please note that the PSID requires registration prior to downloading data. You may wish to register before continuing. To create a sample of grandchild-grandparent pairs, let's begin at the PSID's homepage, psid.org. To start, click on the tab labeled Data at the top of the webpage. This will redirect you to the page containing the FIMS information. Navigate towards the bottom left-hand corner of the page and click on the FIMS link. This link will direct you to the FIMS portion of the PSID website. If you haven't done so already, you'll need to log into the PSID website at this time. Once you've logged in, you'll see this screen and will be able to select the pertinent information to complete this exercise. First, you'll need to select a map type. For this exercise, we want to select the intergenerational GID map because we want to match individuals from the PSID who are from different generations, namely children and grandparents. We also want to use the GID option because we are using the children as our starting point, as we mentioned before, and the intergenerational GID option starts with an individual, in this case the child, and goes back along his or her family lineage, in this example to the grandparents. Once you have selected the intergenerational GID option from the map type box, more options will appear. For parent type, select biological only. Under generation map, choose individual to grandparents. And under map type, choose unbalanced. An unbalanced map refers to a map that will still include observations of children in the CDS who have never had a grandparent identified by the PSID, along with those who have. If you prefer to only keep observations for children who have ever had a grandparent identified by the PSID, select balanced map instead. Again, these choices can be modified, depending on your research question and preferred sample. Under the File Format subheading, select Wide. This option will create one record for each young adult, with variables for each grandparent on that record. The option long creates a record for each grandparent, so that up to 4 records may be generated per young adult. After selecting wide, another option will appear under the file format subheading, labeled Merge with CDS Map. You'll want to check this box as well, because it will instruct FIMS to restrict the dataset to individuals who were in the CDS. This will automatically eliminate many of the observations that are not needed for this exercise. Based on these selections, this file will include 1 record per child, with information for each of the child's grandparents on the child's record. More specifically, we'll see each of the grandparents' 1968 IDs and person numbers as variables on the child's record. We'll use these later to create a unique identifier for each grandparent. To finish this process, choose the SAS V9 system file for the output option, then hit Submit. It will take a minute or so for FIMS to create your dataset. When the file is ready, a link will appear that will allow you to download your FIMS file. Now that we've opened the file in SAS, let's go over what the map allows us to do. The dataset that FIMS creates for you will contain one for each child that appears in either the original or ongoing child development supplement. Since we downloaded an unbalanced map, each young adult has an observation in the file, regardless of whether or not they have a grandparent who was ever identified in the PSID. Their unique identifier can be created by multiplying their 1968 identification number, seen here as variable ER30001, by 1,000, and adding their person number, seen here as the variable labeled ER30002. As an example, an individual with a 1968 ID of 1234 and a person number of 567 would have a unique identifier of 1234567. These identifiers allow you to merge additional variables from the data center with your map. As we scroll through this data map, we see that each corresponding CDS caregiver, parent, and grandparent in this file will also have values for the 1968 ID and person number, or summary variables ER30001 and ER30002. To see explanations of the different types of grandparents, we'll refer first to 1968 interview number, grandparent, father's father. If we look to the variable label, it explains that this grandparent, or GP, is the father's father, or FF. This type of labeling continues for each type of biological grandparent. Each young adult potentially has 4 grandparents in the PSID sample: their mother's father, mother's mother, father's father, and their father's mother. In order to create each grandparent's unique identifier, we would replicate the same process that was done for the grandchild. Looking back to the variable for the father's father, we can see that the paternal grandfather has information for both the 1968 ID and person number. Their unique identifier can be created by using the same process, by multiplying their 1968 identification number by 1,000 and adding their person number. You can repeat this process for any of the 4 types of grandparents whose data are located in the remaining columns of the dataset. If we were to have chosen the option biological or adoptive, our FIMS dataset would have contained additional variables for the young adult's adoptive grandparents. There would be information beyond whether the grandparent is paternal or maternal, including whether the grandparent is a parent of a biological mom or biological dad, or whether the grandparent is the parent of an adoptive mom or dad, or whether the grandparent happens to be an adoptive parent of an adoptive mom or dad of the young adult. Please note that the PSID will not necessarily have information on each grandparent. For example, some individuals might have maternal grandparents who have been surveyed by the PSID, while their paternal grandparents might not have ever been identified in the study. In some cases, we might find that we don't have information about any of the grandparents in the PSID. From here, you'll be able to download any number of variables from the data center for both the young adults and their corresponding grandparents. Once you have merged those separate files with the FIMS map, you'll have a fully linked dataset of young adults and their grandparents from which to start your analysis. This web tutorial was produced by Nora Insulera and Vicky Friedman with funding from the National Institute on Aging. This ends the web tutorial on the PSID's Family Identification Mapping System. Comments and questions may be sent to psidhelp@umich.edu.